this evening to all here present, to all clergy present, especially to Bishop Mayer, and welcome to all of this congregation here who are here to support IO in this journey of ordination to the Sacred Order of Deacons in the Episcopal Church. Welcome and special thanks to IO's wife, Topi, and his entire family who have supported him in his second calling to holy orders. Your willingness to support him in that struggle to discern his place in the Lord's plan is a journey of love, a journey of togetherness, a journey of support and prayer. It's fitting that we gather for this beautiful ordination ceremony during Advent, a time of waiting, a time of expectation, a time of quiet contemplation. For we're honored to present tonight a man who has waited patiently through years of study and prayer. Years. A man who has met our fondest expectations of what a deacon is all about. And that is service. True service. A man of quiet and contemplative manner. One who has openly shown us peace and concern for others in his everyday life. We're here tonight to honor Ayo, who has led that life of service to others from his very first days as a boy in Nigeria. As he continued his education in the United States, he found more opportunities to serve and has always looked for that moment of service. He has shown the heart and soul of a deacon in all of his work with young people in trouble and with everyone in this parish. He has served the people of his home parish wherever he has lived, especially at St. Barnabas in Odessa, where he was for some time, and here at St.Martin-in-the-Fields. He studied the scriptures, and no better passage applies to him than the reading we have heard from Jeremiah. Do not say, I am only a boy, for you shall go to all whom I send you. You shall speak whatever I command you. And then the Lord put out his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord said to me, now I put my words in your mouth. And I, whenever you speak, you feel the Lord's touch on your mouth. The words will come to you. You can be much comforted by these words. The Lord will indeed touch your mouth and your heart when you need it most. I remember only too well that as a new deacon, I was afraid that I would say the wrong thing at the wrong time. And of course, that happens sometimes. Here, probably way too often. But my heart was in the right place. And the Lord helped me move on to words with more meaning and with more compassion. And sometimes with no words at all, only with silence, only the presence of the Spirit with me and the one other person I was with. And as I became more involved in work as a hospital chaplain, I experienced more response from people in a day than I did in a month as a parish deacon. Responses that went from, get out, I don't want to talk to anybody, to an hour's conversation that involved laughter and crying and confession and all the gamut of human emotions. But often it boiled down to long moments of silent pastoral presence. Moments where no words were spoken. These moments, as much a part of God's presence in that room as in any prayers that we could say out loud. As Paul Newman said once in a movie, sometimes no hand at all is a pretty cool hand. And sometimes the Lord lets us make a pretty cool connect with those who need our help with only a little bit of silence, only a little bit of listening, only our presence, only ourselves open and speechless in the presence of grief, in the presence of trouble, and that, yes, in the presence of joy. So never ask where I will find those words. They will come to you, Ayo. And if not, then the Lord's helping you to show your compassion with your simple presence. And most importantly, God's presence. Now we as deacons are blessed with the promise of a place at the table, a place of service. Just like our Lord Jesus tells us in our gospel reading today from Luke, we are honored to set that table. We are honored to, as Mother Lauren once told me, do up the dishes after the feast. But principally, we as deacons are called to make Jesus real in a world that needs healing, that needs to hear the good news. We are granted as deacons an authority and a summons to serve Christ outside the walls of this church in all ways to all persons and in all places. So wear that authority as a cloak. Wear it proudly, because that authority to tell the good news, heal broken hearts, comfort the sick and depressed, that authority is yours to use as God directs you, day by day, minute by minute. It's the call to serve. To serve. All God's people will be this day recognized and granted to you by the faithful presence of the Holy Spirit. It's an authority that no one can challenge, an authority filled with humility, yet confidence, an authority you will be granted by God and by this congregation and by our bishop, mayor. In addition, what we do here this evening with the ordination of you, Io, is to remind and challenge anew every deacon, every priest, every bishop to live out their diaconal ordination. The very starting point of clergy ministry. And indeed reflecting the ministry of all the baptized, all who recognize servanthood for all Christians. Servanthood, the heart of the diaconal life. A life of more than just an occasional concern for someone. A life of more than just a glance at someone who may be in need. But one that recognizes true sacrifice on behalf of others in the name of the God who guides us by the Holy Spirit. So as deacons, we are never alone. We're never alone. I think this is the most important gift of what we do. God is always with us. God is always in us. And we serve as deacons together with our fellow clergy, with each of you who support us from this parish, and with support from our bishop who confirms us, sustains us, and pastors us in our journey of servanthood. So Io, as a deacon, you take God's gift of love and respect to all people and leave them with hope. Your offering of your life to this new calling gives us all hope. We are blessed every day by your presence and that of your family. And make no mistake, your family, everyone in your family, everyone in your extended family that serves the people of God in every way, and we at St. Martin's, we are all privileged to present you, Io, for ordination to the Sacred Order of Deacons in the Episcopal Church. Congratulations, and may God be with you as you serve all people in his holy name.